Everything we know about galaxies could be changing thanks to this key discovery, and honestly, I'm really excited. Hello and welcome back to Inform Overload. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today we're talking about space, galaxies, and our fundamental understanding of how they work. Before we launch like a rocket right on into this video, I just want to invite you to like our videos if you love IO. Also, I want you to keep thinking throughout the video, because at the end, I would love to hear your thoughts on space and the wider cosmos. So back to the story. In all galaxies we have observed so far, there is one key ingredient, and that is dark matter. Dark matter makes up most of the matter in the universe, around 80% of it actually. This strange ingredient doesn't emit light or energy. In fact, we don't even really know what it is, we just know that it's there. We have a few suspicions though. Some scientists think it is non-baryonic matter, which, if we were gonna super simplify things, we could say were very heavy particles. Anyway, once again, dark matter was assumed to be a very key ingredient in the makeup of our galaxies. However, one galaxy we have recently observed seems to be lacking in this ingredient that we thought was so vital. Galaxy NGC-1051-DF2 seems to be lacking in dark matter. Now, before we get into the science, I just want to rewind for a second, because NGC-1051-DF2, I'm sorry, but who is naming these galaxies? Why can't we call it like Bruce or Titan or something? Like, give a galaxy a chance. No one's gonna remember that. Anyway, Yale astronomer Peter Van Dokkum and a team of researchers studied the speed of 10 bright star clumps. These are called globular clusters. Now, they were actually moving a lot slower than expected, indicating that they were in a dark matter-free zone. Now, this is very problematic for scientists who had previously based their understanding of physics on the presence of dark matter. Astrophysicist at Case Western Reserve University in Cleveland spoke out about the finding. Now, he said he was totally baffled. He said it wasn't clear how such a galaxy could form in the first place. Now, the general consensus amongst scientists is that the lack of dark matter could challenge what we know about the universe, and it may even give us some more clues in our quest to understanding. This is what I love about science. It is always open to being challenged. In fact, science welcomes challenge. It's comforting to me to know that we don't always have the answers, that what we know isn't totally fixed, but could be open to better explanations. So, what do you guys think to this? I know nobody watching will be able to provide an answer on how a galaxy can form without dark matter, but isn't it exciting? Before I go, I just want to reply to a few comments from one of my videos yesterday about flat earthers. Orlando Rod Val said, "It's a square, hadn't y'all looked at Minecraft?" Gabriel Sorgren Frey wrote, "Stupid people, the Earth is obviously a triangle," whereas Chloe Huff said, "I think the Earth is a cube." This is all pretty great, and I really like that we can have fun here at IO. I think we can all agree how ridiculous and absurd some of the stories are, so yeah. Thank you guys for tuning into this episode. Let me know what you think to this story. Let me know your thoughts on dark matter. Also, anyone else got any ideas what shape the Earth could be? I think it's a nonagon, just mostly because I wanted to say nonagon. Nonagon! 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 See? We all feel better now. It's gonna be a good day. Thank you guys for tuning into this episode of IO. I'm Rebecca Felgate. Make sure you leave a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and stay subscribed for more daily news. Nonagon you next time.